ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर इरम। आई एम प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट फिजियोलॉजी एट एफआरपीएमसी। माय ईमेल एड्रेस इज drerumimran@gmail.com। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज हीमोस्टेसिस। Find any difficulty, any queries regarding this lecture, you can contact me on my personal email address. Okay, now let's discuss the learning objectives of this lecture. At the end of the lecture, you should be able to define what hemostasis is and enumerate the various stages of hemostasis. Discuss the difference between primary and secondary hemostasis. Discuss various factors responsible for vascular spasm. Discuss the genesis of platelets, its morphology and lifespan. Discuss the cell membrane of platelets and granules present in the platelets with their contents. Discuss the steps of platelet plug formation. Discuss the importance of platelet plug in closing micro leaks in the vessel wall. So these are the learning objectives. Okay. So now let's see what the word hemostasis means. Heme means blood and stasis means stoppage. So the word hemostasis means stoppage of bleeding or prevention of blood loss. So whenever there is an injury to the blood vessel, what will happen? The blood is going to ooze out. It will come out, and through a series of reaction, after some time, this bleeding will stop due to a formation of semi-solid or jelly-like substance, which is known as a clot. Means after some time, a blood clot is formed, which seal the vessel and prevent further loss of blood. Okay, so this hemostatic mechanism, you will see that it involves the interaction of blood vessel, platelets and clotting factors. So there is interplay of three things. One is blood vessel, other is platelets, and third is the clotting factors. So this hemostasis word is different from another word which you studied in the first chapter of physiology, that is homeostasis. Okay, there is a difference between hemostasis and homeostasis. Homeostasis was the maintenance of the constant internal environment, and this hemostasis means prevention of blood loss or stoppage of bleeding. Okay, now what are the stages of hemostasis? The stages of hemostasis can be divided into primary and secondary. Okay, you can divide two stages are present in primary and two stages are present in secondary. So total there are four stages of hemostasis. The two primary are the vascular spasm and platelet plug formation. The secondary features, they are actually the clot formation and clot retraction and fibrinolysis. So there are four stages of hemostasis. Two are the primary. One is vascular spasm and platelet plug formation. They are both included in the primary hemostasis, and clot formation, that is also known as coagulation, and clot retraction and fibrinolysis, they are included in the secondary hemostasis. So now what does this hemostasis is doing? That it preventing the hemorrhage from small blood vessels like capillaries, arterioles, venules. Ab inse blood jo hemorrhage ho raha hai usse prevent kar raha hai hemostasis, not from the large arteries. For example, if someone has cut his or her large artery, what will happen? You won't wait for the hemostatic mechanism to actually repair that blood vessel. Okay, it's an extensive hemorrhage, it's a medical emergency, and the person has to go immediately to the hospital. It cannot be closed by the clot or the or these pathways. They are not actually responsible for the process of clot formation and if the large artery is has been ruptured. And arterial bleeding will be more profuse. ठीक है ना, आर्टीरियल आर्टरीज में पल्सेशंस होती हैं, इसलिए उसमें ज्यादा ब्लीडिंग होगी, बहुत तेजी से ब्लड निकलेगा. इट विल बी मोर प्रोफ्यूज एंड डेंजरस एज कंपेयर टू वीनस ब्लीडिंग. सो वेन एवर देर इज अ लार्ज हेमरेज, इट्स अ मेडिकल इमरजेंसी, बट दिस हीमोस्टेसिस इज एक्चुअली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन प्रिवेंटिंग द हेमरेज फ्रॉम स्मॉल ब्लड वेसल्स, ओके, विच एक्चुअली विच आर ट्रॉमाटाइज बाय माइनर ट्रॉमास. And then they can be repaired by these hemostatic mechanisms. So let's revise. What are the four hemostatic mechanisms? They are two primary and two secondary. Primary actually includes vascular spasm, platelet plug formation, and secondary includes clot formation and clot retraction and fibrinolysis. Okay. So in this slide you can see that whenever there is a vessel is damaged, you can see the vessel is damaged, blood is coming out, the first reaction you can see here what is happening, the vessel get constricted, hai na, jab vessel will get constricted naturally less flow flow of blood will occur, so less blood will move out. Jab blood hi kam aa raha hai due to vasoconstriction to loss bhi kam ho jayega. So this is a very important that immediately the when the vessel is damaged, the vessel wall, or there is a vasoconstriction in the vessel wall. Second, you can see all the platelets, they come and they adhere over here, they aggregate and then they form a platelet plug. They form a plug which stops the bleeding and that is known as a platelet plug. This platelet plug, then it is actually it is strengthened by the fibrin threads. Now the fibrin threads, this process is known as the coagulation or clotting, in which the fibrin threads are formed. This is the proper clot, okay, this is the platelet plug, this is the proper clot when fibrin threads are formed, and finally this is the fibrinolysis, in which the fibrin clot which was formed, now it is dissolved. So the vessel is now healed and blood now flows normally. There is a continuous flow of blood. Yahan par dekh rahe ho, blood ruk gaya hai actually due to platelet plug. There is no smooth flow. But here, once the vessel is repaired and your fibrin is dissolved, your vessel is repaired and the blood now flows normally. So these two reactions, the above reactions, the vessel wall constriction and platelet plug formation, that is actually included in the primary hemostasis, then the formation of fibrin thread, and this fibrin when dissolved and vessel is healed, and this process is known as fibrinolysis, and this two, the clot and fibrinolysis, they are included in the secondary hemostasis. Okay, okay, now let's start the primary hemostatic mechanisms, which include number one, the vascular spasm. Now let's look at the detail of the vascular spasm. That whenever there is injury or trauma to the blood vessel, what will happen? The immediate effect is that that blood vessel starts to contract. Okay, immediately it starts to contract and reduce the blood loss. है ना, कुछ blood loss reduce हो जाएगा. When less blood is flowing through this constricted vessel, what will happen? Less blood is going to ooze out. So by this time, when the vessel is getting constrict, other hemostatic mechanisms, they have not been operational. जैसे अभी platelet plug बनने में time लगेगा, clot बनने में time लगेगा, तो immediately क्या चीज हो जाएगी? Vascular spasm हो जाएगा. Okay, and spasm is so marked, you can see that the lumen, इसका जो lumen है vessel का, is almost obliterated. बिल्कुल छोटा सा रह गया lumen. ओके, एंड टू सर्फेसिस, ये जो दोनों सर्फेसिस हैं बिल्कुल एक दूसरे के करीब आ गई हैं. ल्यूमन ऑब्लिट्रेट हो गया है एंड दिस एक्चुअली मिनिमाइजेस द ब्लड लॉस फॉर ओनली फ्यू सेकेंड्स. बाय द टाइम अदर हीमोस्टेटिक मैकेनिज्म दे बिकम ऑपरेशनल. ओके, Now, what are the causes of vascular spasm? What may be the causes of vascular spasm? Kyun ho raha hai? The most important cause is the nervous. There are three important causes actually. The nervous reflex, the local myogenic reflex, and third is the hormonal factors. So nervous reflex, jaise damage hui vessel wall, injury hua, what happened? That there is a pain, and pain is going to initiate the nervous reflex, that sympathetic nervous system gets activated and which causes the constriction of the blood vessel. Theek hai? Aapka pain se shuru ho gaya. Pain is actually activating the nervous signal, that is a sympathetic nervous system, and which results in vasoconstriction. Second is the local myogenic, means the muscle. Kahan par hai? Local, yani in the vessel wall, there is the smooth muscle. Okay, whenever there is a damage to the vessel wall, what happened? That naturally is wall mein, there is also a smooth muscle also, and it start constricting due to the damage to the vessel wall. Okay, so second is the local myogenic mechanism, that myogenic means muscular, and the muscle in the smooth muscle get activated due to the damage and it starts contracting. So vasoconstriction ho jayegi. The third is the local hormonal factors which arise from the damaged tissue and platelets over there. Okay, ab yahan jo aapka aap dekh rahe ho ki iski ek lining hai, endothelium hai, jo inner lining hai is the endothelium hai, then is the muscle layer bhi nazar aa raha hai aapko. Ab ye jo endothelium hai, this when damages it release endothelin. The endothelin is very important hormone which is actually released from the damaged endothelium. It's actually it's actually the autopoid. ये वहीं से release हो रहा है. आपको अगर signaling का mechanism में याद हो कि वहीं कुछ hormones या कुछ signal molecules एक जगह से release होते हैं और उन्हीं के ऊपर act करते हैं, उसी organ के ऊपर, है ना, जहाँ से release हो रहे हैं. So they are acting on the same blood vessel from where they are released. So this mechanism of cell signaling is known as autocrine. So this is autopoid ho gaya ye, hai na? It's released from the damaged vessel. The endothelial cells, they release endothelin, and this endothelin is actually a very powerful vasoconstrictor. Moreover, jo platelets wahan aa rahi hain, unse bhi later the platelets, they also release ADP, serotonin and thromboxane A2. ठीक है, हम आगे पढ़ेंगे इसको डिटेल में जब हम प्लेटलेट्स पढ़ेंगे. तो प्लेटलेट्स से भी कुछ चीजें फैक्टर्स रिलीज हो रहे हैं, कुछ हॉर्मोन्स, एंड विच आर एडीपी, सीरोटोनिन एंड थ्रोम्बोक्सेन A2. दीज आर आल्सो पावरफुल वैसोकंस्ट्रिक्टर्स. सो देयर आर थ्री फैक्टर्स, द नर्वस फैक्टर, द मायोजेनिक फैक्टर, एंड द थर्ड इज द हॉर्मोनल फैक्टर्स. Now which hormones? Endothelin, which is released from endothelium, which is ruptured endothelium. So you can easily learn E for endothelin, and E for endothelium means endothelin is released from ruptured or damaged endothelium. And ADP, serotonin and thromboxane, these three, they are released from the platelets. And all these four substances, they are responsible for the vasoconstriction in the blood vessel. So vasospasm ke factors aapko yaad ho gaye, nervous reflex, myogenic reflex and hormonal factors. Okay, so second mechanism of hemostasis is the platelet plug formation. Actually this platelet plug, it can seal micro leaks. Chote chote jo leaks hote hai na, wo to platelet plug se hi क्लोज हो जाते हैं, सील हो जाते हैं. ठीक है, व्हेन देयर इज अ स्मॉल कट, इट इज ऑफन सील्ड बाय प्लेटलेट प्लग रादर देन बाय अ क्लॉट. क्लॉट बनने की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ती, वो सील हो जाता है. ठीक है, व्हाट हैपेंस एक्चुअली, जब डेली व्हेन योर ब्लड इज फ्लोइंग, तेजी से जब ब्लड फ्लो करता है तो स्मॉल स्मॉल जो होते हैं ना, एक छोटे 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 ना होल्स बन जाते हैं ब्लड वेसल्स में डेली, एंड दोज होल्स दे आर सील्ड बाय द प्लेटलेट प्लग. प्लेटलेट्स उनको सील भी करता रहता है. ठीक है, ये एक नेचुरल प्रोसेस है विच इज गोइंग डेली विद इन ईच डे. देर आर मेनी प्लग्स, मेनी रेंट्स दे अकर इन द ब्लड वेसल, माइनर माइनर होते रहते हैं, लीक्स होते रहते हैं, and that they are sealed by the platelet flux. No clot is required. Okay, and they can close the small plugs, small leaks, but they cannot seal the larger holes in the vessel for which the clotting is must. Got it? सिर्फ ये small leaks को seal कर सकता है. तो platelet plug के different stages हैं. There are three stages of platelet plug formation. First of all is the adhesion, means the platelet, they go and adhere. Once they adhere, they activate, they gets activated and release some substances, and then there is aggregation. So remember three A's of the platelet plug. What are three A's? Platelet adhesion, platelet activation and platelet aggregation. Okay, these are the three stages. We'll discuss in detail. There are three stages, three A's: adhesion, activation and aggregation. So before we go to the platelet plug formation, let's discuss what the platelets are and how they are derived. Platelets, they are also known as thrombocytes, as you know. So let's see what are the platelets. Okay, this slide, actually it is showing the hemopoiesis. Now we are discussing platelets, so we will focus only on the synthesis and the development and maturation of platelets actually. And what hemopoiesis is for the synthesis of all the blood cells, that is the red blood cells and white blood cells. You have studied both of these cells. Now we will focus only the formation of the platelets. Here we can see that like other cells of the blood, all the cells, they are derived from the pluripotent hemopoietic stem cells which are present in the bone marrow, which then forms the colony forming unit spleen, which give rise to three cell lineages. This will form erythrocyte, this will form granulocyte, monocyte, and the other one will form the colony forming unit megakaryocyte. Now these three cells, they are the committed stem cells because they are committed to form only one cell lineage. For example, the colony forming unit megakaryocyte is committed to form a large cell which is known as megakaryocyte. Mega means large and cyte means cell. So it is forming a very large size cell which is known as megakaryocyte, and this megakaryocyte will fragment into many platelets. One megakaryocyte form large number of platelets. So this is the thrombopoiesis, है ना? ये खाली अगर हम thrombocytes, platelets are also known as thrombocytes. So if you focus on this cell lineage, so this is known as thrombopoiesis, means the formation of blood platelets. Pluripotent hemopoietic stem cells form colony forming unit spleen, which forms colony forming unit megakaryocytes, which are committed stem cells, and they form megakaryocytes, which forms the platelets. Okay, so here you can see that these are the pluripotent hemopoietic stem cells. First they are converted into megakaryoblast, then promegakaryocytes, then are the megakaryocytes. You don't have to remember the features of all these cells, but just to remember that the pluripotent hemopoietic, these are the stem cells which are present in the bone marrow, and they go through different stages and they form the megakaryocyte, which is the last cell. And the platelets, they are actually nothing but they are the fragments of these last cells. One cell gives about 1,000 of platelets. So they are small tiny bits of fragments which arise from the megakaryocytes. They are very small, round or oval in shape, and their diameter is about 2 to 4 micrometers in diameter. Hai na, bahut chote se, 2 to 4 micrometers in diameter. The normal count, you all know, 1.5 to 4.5 lakhs per cubic millimeter. And there is a hormone thrombopoietin. It's just like erythropoietin. Erythropoietin mainly kidney se release ho raha tha, but the thrombopoietin is produced by the liver and it's actually increases the it stimulates the bone marrow cells to increase the formation of the platelets. So thrombopoietin is actually increasing the number of precursor cells in the bone marrow, and it is produced by the liver. Here you can see that this is the summarized form, that platelets, they are small, round and oval in shape. They are the fragments of the large cell, that is the megakaryocyte, and a single megakaryocyte produce about 1000 platelets. The lifespan is about 10 days and they are eliminated from circulation by tissue macrophages. They are phagocytized by tissue macrophages. They are granulated, means they have granules which secrete important secretions. We will see their diameter is 2 to 4 micrometers in diameter, and their count is about 150,000 to 400,000 या 450 तक की रेंज है उसकी. ठीक है, लाइफ स्पैन इज अबाउट 8 to 10 डेज है, एंड आफ्टर दिस दे आर एलिमिनेटेड फ्रॉम द सर्कुलेशन बाय टिश्यू मैक्रोफेजेस. ओके, नाउ दिस स्लाइड एक्चुअली शोज द वी आर डिस्कसिंग द प्लेटलेट्स. नाउ दिस इज द सेल मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द प्लेटलेट्स. The platelet cell membrane is, again, it is made up of phospholipid like other cells. So this phospholipid is converted into arachidonic acid by the enzyme phospholipase A2. This arachidonic acid is then acted upon by the enzyme cyclooxygenase, and it is converted into thromboxane A2, which is, you must remember that this thromboxane A2 is a powerful vasoconstrictor. It causes a vascular spasm in the first stage of the hemostasis. And वहाँ पर पढ़ा था हमने thromboxane A2, which is released from the platelets and which causes vasospasm. And second function of thromboxane A2 is actually it causes platelet aggregation. Okay, it causes platelet aggregation. So clumping होती है. Now aspirin. Aspirin is actually is a drug which inhibits this enzyme. So it inhibits this enzyme, so it prevents what? It prevents the platelet aggregation. So platelets, they do not clump together, so help in reducing or preventing the blood clots. So that's why it's given to a patient of heart attack, and it prevents the formation of blood clots in the coronary artery. So that's why it's very important drug, and it acts on the enzyme cyclooxygenase. So there are two functions of thromboxane A2, that is platelet aggregation and vasoconstriction. Okay, similarly in the endothelial cells, where are the endothelial cells? They line the blood vessels. So the in the blood vessels, the again there are the there is the phospholipid layer in this cell also, endothelial cell. Over there the arachidonic acid is actually converted into prostacyclin. Okay, prostacyclin, and this is actually a prostaglandin, and this inhibits the aggregation. Thromboxane A2 and prostacyclin has got opposite actions. This is vasoconstrictor and platelet aggregator. This is vasodilator, and it inhibits the aggregation. Okay, so this is the how the thromboxane A2 is generated in the platelets and how it causes the platelet aggregation. And second, the cell membrane of the platelets, it has got three main receptors for binding with the collagen, for binding with the von Willebrand factor and fibrinogen. Okay, yahan par iske receptors hain. We'll see in next slide that it has got different type of receptors which can bind with collagen, von Willebrand factor and fibrinogen. So in this slide you can see the receptors present in the platelets. These are the platelets,
and this is actually the cell capillary wall, or the actually is the blood vessel wall, and these are the endothelial cells. You can see these are the endothelial cells with the nucleus. Okay, and now what you can see that there are different type of receptors which are present on the platelet surface. Now here you can see that this is a von Willebrand factor. This von Willebrand factor, it is at one place, it is adherent to this vessel wall, and it is also adherent to the platelet. Okay, it binds with the platelets. So this factor is very important, and it helps in platelet aggregation. How we look forward, but you can see that it can bind with the platelet and also with the collagen present in the endothelial cells, beneath the endothelial cells, actually subendothelium ke agar aap dekho niche endothelium ke niche, it is binding with the vessel wall, and it also binds with the platelets. Second, you can see platelets has a receptors. You don't need to memorize these receptors, just you know that you should know that they are the receptors for the fibrinogen. Fibrinogen is going to bind over here, you can see here, and I think it's not shown that how it binds with the collagen. It has the receptors which directly bind with the collagen also. Platelet has receptors which bind with the collagen. Where is collagen? Collagen is present in this subendothelium connective tissue hai jo niche blood vessel ke andar, uske andar it is going to bind with the collagen. It binds with the fibrinogen and it binds with the von Willebrand factor. Now let's see what is the von Willebrand factor. Actually, von Willebrand factor is a glycoprotein, and it is secreted both from the endothelium and the platelets. Okay, the endothelial cells. Now here the structure of the capillary or the blood vessel wall is very much clear, that it has a lining which is known as the endothelium. You can see endothelium, then is the basement membrane, and then is the subendothelial structure, which is connective tissue and which is rich in collagen. It is made up of collagen. So now the one, this dots, these dots actually they are the von Willebrand factor. Now this von Willebrand factor has very important two functions. One, I told you that it binds with the platelet, and also it binds with the collagen. You can see that it binds with the collagen and it's binding with the platelet also. So it helps in the adhesion of platelet with the collagen, and so collagen is actually, platelet can bind with the collagen directly, and also it can bind via von Willebrand factor. So this von Willebrand factor plays a very important role in binding of platelet with the collagen. ठीक है, glue का काम कर रहा है दोनों के बीच में. ये collagen है और ये प्लेटलेट है, इनके बीच में ग्लू का काम कौन कर रहा है? वॉन विलिब्रेंड फैक्टर. सो दिस फैक्टर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट हेल्प्स इन द प्लेटलेट एग्रीगेशन और प्लेटलेट एडहेशन एक्चुअली. ठीक है, नाउ सेकंड इज हियर यू कैन सी दैट, बट हियर इट इज नॉट प्रेजेंट दैट दिस वॉन विलिब्रेंड फैक्टर, इट ऑल्सो बाइंड विद अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर, दैट इज क्लॉटिंग फैक्टर 8. इट बाइंड विद द फैक्टर 8 when the factor 8 is inactive. It binds with the inactivated factor 8. If it will not bind with the inactive factor 8, the factor 8 is going to rapidly destroy. Khatam ho jata hai agar factor 8 se von Willebrand factor bind nahi hota. Theek hai, so one, it actually stabilizes the factor 8. Without von Willebrand factor, the factor 8 is going to be degraded. Okay, so there are two important functions. One is platelet adhesion, and second is it actually stabilizes the factor 8. Okay, so it binds with platelets. We have seen that it binds with the platelets and it also binds with the collagen. Ab collagen normal blood vessel mein to nahi hoga, to kab bind karega collagen se? Whenever there is a damage to the blood vessel. Whenever there is a damage from the damage to the blood vessel, this von Willebrand factor binds the with the collagen and helps the platelets to bind with the wall of the vessel. So now let's discuss the cytoplasm of the platelets. We have discussed the cell membrane of the platelets, the receptors which are present on the cell membrane, and now the platelets cytoplasm. This is the cytoplasm of the platelets. We'll look for only the important structures. It has no nucleus. You can see no nucleus, no DNA, no RNA, so it cannot reproduce. Okay. It has endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus. So it can synthesize enzymes and store calcium. The functions of endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus over here is to synthesize some enzymes and also store calcium ions. Lysosomes bhi hain, which actually have lysosomal enzymes like hydrolases. It also has mitochondria, which provides energy. It also has enzymes to synthesize prostaglandins. We discussed that it has got phospholipase A2, it has got cyclooxygenase, and it can form thromboxane A2. So it has enzymes to form the prostaglandins. And one very important thing, you can see that it has got high concentrations of actin, myosin and thrombosthenin. These three actually, they are responsible for causing the platelets to contract. So this we'll discuss that it has a very important role in clot retraction. The platelets, they contract and they retract the clot due to the presence of actin, myosin and thrombosthenin. We'll do this afterwards. Now in the cytoplasm of the platelets, there are very important granules. Two important granules are present in the cytoplasm. Beside the organelles we discussed and actin, myosin and thrombosthenin, there are two types of granules. The alpha granules and the dense or the delta granules. Delta granules asaan hai. Iske andar jo hai, teen substance mainly produced ho rahe. They are actually unko easy hai. Sac. If you remember this word sac, you can say that what are secretions from the dense or the delta granules. S is for serotonin. A is for ADP and ATP. And C is for calcium. So they produce the dense or the delta granules of the platelets. It produces the non-protein substances. Okay, whenever the platelets get activated, they release these substances from their granules. So the dense or the delta granules secrete three types of secretions. One is serotonin, ATP or ADP, and C is for calcium ions. We look for the functions afterwards. Now the alpha granules. The alpha granules secrete the protein substances and the clotting factors. Now they release certain things. What are those? Fibrinogen, which is the clotting factor, platelet thromboplastin, von Willebrand factor. We discussed that von Willebrand factor is released from endothelial cells and also for platelets. Other clotting factors, 5, 8 and 13. They are also released from the liver, but they are also released from the platelets. Platelet and different growth factors, they are also released, like platelet drive growth factor, endothelial growth factor and platelet activating factor. So these are different type of granules, alpha and dense. Dense, it produces sac, and alpha, they are protein and clotting factors. Kaun-kaun-si clotting factors hain? 5, 8, 13 and fibrinogen. Fibrinogen is also a clotting factor. Then is the platelet thromboplastin, von Willebrand factor and growth factors hain. Theek hai? So the important function of some substance, of some secretions from the platelet granule is very important, that it thromboxane A2. Kya function tha iske? Iske do bahut important function hai thromboxane A2 ke, that it is causing vasoconstriction. So it helps in the vasospasm. the first stage of primary hemostasis, and second function is platelet aggregation, platelet ki clumping karta, theek hai. Thromboxane A2B और ADP. ADP कहाँ से release हो रहा है? Dense granules से, ठीक है? ADP is released from the dense granules. We discussed in the last slide that ABP is released from dense or the delta granules, and thromboxane A2 is formed by the membrane phospholipid. Both of these, they are responsible for the platelet aggregation. Okay? F13 factor is very important. We will see that factor number 13, it helps in the stabilization of the clot. It strengthens the clot. Okay? And different type of growth factors, the platelet drive growth factors and the endothelial growth factors, they all cause the multiplication and growth of vascular endothelial cells. ठीक है ना? जब आपके endothelial cells हैं, उनकी growth कौन से कर रहा है? That is the platelet drive growth factor and the endothelial growth factor. They help in the growth of the blood vessel. Now this slide is showing overall functions. अब हम देख लेते हैं क्या-क्या functions हो रहे हैं. ठीक है? अब क्या-क्या platelet के functions हैं? It secrete powerful vasoconstrictors. कौन सा था? Thromboxane A2. So to reduce the blood loss. है ना? Vascular spasm. आपका primary hemostasis का पहला step था vascular spasm. ताकि blood loss कम हो. ठीक है? And that was provided by the thromboxane A2. एक तो ये होगा. Stick together and form temporary plug. ठीक है? ये हम देखेंगे कि second stage था हमारा primary hemostasis का. First was vascular spasm. Second was the platelet plug formation. तो platelets का एक बहुत important function हो गया that it helps in the platelet plug formation. इसके अलावा it secretes clotting factors and help in blood clotting. Which clotting factors are released? 5, 8 and 13 and fibrinogen. ठीक है? Fibrinogen is factor 1. ठीक है? Fibrinogen is factor number 1. Now its phospholipid membrane is very important in clotting pathway. Clotting pathway के लिए ये phospholipid बहुत important है. कैसे है? We'll see in, when we'll study the clotting pathways. And it also secrete growth factors. We have discussed that it helps in the release of growth factors, which helps to stimulate the mitosis process in fibroblast and vascular endothelial cells, smooth muscle cells. सबकी growth और development करती है इन cells की, so that mitosis हो उसमें and their cells increase in number, and this help in maintaining and repair the blood vessels. है ना? वहाँ fibrosis, fibrous tissue आ जाता है, fibroblast आते हैं, उनकी growth, जो endothelial cells they are damaged, उनकी repair, उनकी growth, and इसके अलावा जो है smooth muscles which are present in the wall of the vessel. All these cells, they actually grow in the presence of different growth factors which are derived from the platelets. That's why they are known as platelet-derived growth factors. Okay, jo growth karte hain so that to repair the injured blood vessel. So, now we'll see the very important function of that of the platelet, that is the platelet plug formation. You can see that this is a platelet plug which is formed. Okay, now here is the blood vessel. This is the endothelial. This is lumen of the blood vessel. Okay, yahan blood ja raha hai. Endothelium hai yahan blood vessel rupture ho gayi hai. This is endothelium. This is subendothelial structure. Isme collagen present hai. ये कोलेजन है, एक्सपोज्ड कोलेजन एक्सपोज्ड हो गया. अगर ये नहीं होता तो ये पूरा स्मूथ कोलेजन अंदर होता. दिस इज द स्मूथनेस ऑफ द वॉल. नाउ द स्मूथनेस ऑफ द वॉल हैज बीन इंटरप्टेड बिकॉज़ द वेसल इज डैमेज्ड एंड द कोलेजन इज एक्सपोज्ड व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन द सब एंडोथेलियम. देन इज द स्मूथ मसल लेयर एंड देन इज द दिस जो है बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन है एंड दिस इज द वेसल और ये बाहर वेसल इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड है ये बाहर. So this is the blood vessel. Okay? So very important function. We have discussed the primary hemostasis, which has got two important processes. One is the vascular spasm and other is the platelet blood formation. So now let's discuss the platelet formation. In the platelet blood formation, I told you that remember three A's. Okay? The first A is platelet adhesion. Platelet adhesion. Okay, whenever the blood vessel loses its smoothness and underlying collagen is exposed. And the collagen exposed ho gaya. So von Willebrand factor will leak into traumatized tissue and it attracts platelets. Why it attracts platelets? Because it has receptors. You know, jab aapka trauma hua, von Willebrand factor kahan se release hota hai? Platelets se or endothelial cells se. Von Willebrand factor will be released and this von Willebrand factor will help the platelets to get attached to the collagen. ठीक है और ये अटैच हो जाएगा खुद वॉन विलिब्रेंड फैक्टर ग्लू का काम करेगा और प्लेटलेट को अटैच कर देगा विद द एक्सपोज्ड कोलेजन ठीक है सो दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज प्लेटलेट अडहेशन प्लेटलेट डायरेक्टली भी अडहेयर हो जाएंगे कोलेजन से क्योंकि दे हैव द रिसेप्टर्स टू बाइंड विद द कोलेजन एंड दे बाइंड विद द वॉन विलिब्रेंड फैक्टर विच हेल्प्स इन बाइंडिंग ऑफ प्लेटलेट टू द एक्सपोज्ड कोलेजन So this process is known as platelet adhesion. So whenever platelet go and adhere, they gets activated. Second, वो उसी के अंदर platelet जैसे ही adhere होती हैं, तो वो active हो जाती हैं. What? How they will now look when they get activated? They begin to swell and they have spines. इनके projections नजर आने शुरू जाएंगे. ऐसी हो जाएंगी platelets. These are the platelets. Once they bind, they show these projections. Okay, from the surface. Now they have become activated. Okay, and once they get activated, they release their substances from the granules, which is known as platelet release reactions. Platelet release reactions. Okay, so once they get activated they release the substances from their granules so kya hua sabse pehle platelet adhere damage hua vessel wall se platelet adhere directly to the collagen or through the von Willebrand factor this is known as platelet adhesion second is adhesion results in activation of the platelets spines aa gaye aur dusra they release their secretions okay And through from the granules, and this is known as platelet release reaction. So platelet activation हुई और फिर substances release हो गए. अब क्या-क्या secretions थी उसकी? अगर आपको याद हो, दो तरह के granules थे. Important secretions की हम खाली बात करेंगे यहाँ पर अभी कि ADP and thromboxane A2. ADP and thromboxane A2 आपको याद होगा कि दिस टू आर अ पावरफुल प्लेटलेट एग्रीगेटर ये दोनों क्या करते हैं दे डू प्लेटलेट एग्रीगेशन प्लेटलेट एडहेर हो गए थे प्लेटलेट एक्टिवेट हो गए थे प्लेटलेट दे रिलीज सब्सटेंसेस एंड द टू इंपॉर्टेंट सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच आर रिलीज्ड दैट इज ADP एंड थ्रोम्बोक्सेन A2 व्हाट दे डू दे कॉज द platelet aggregation they call or they activate the nearby platelets and stickness and this cause look at here you can see that yahan khali ek platelet se ab aur platelet aana shuru ho gaye aur attract ho rahe kaun attract kar raha hai that is ADP and thromboxane A2 which are released from the dense granules and they help in the aggregation of further more platelets okay and it is causing platelet aggregation okay to humne kiya ke platelet ki aggregation platelet aggregation starts they adhere one to one another now look at here that what happens that the platelets they stick and adhere to one another and forming layers and after layers and attracting more and more platelets and they will seal the actually the hole in the blood vessel. Okay, so this is a temporary seam, and naturally then the process of clotting will start and a permanent clot will start. So this is platelet aggregation. एक प्लेटलेट आई, उसने दूसरे को बुलाया, क्योंकि उससे क्या रिलीज हुआ, थ्रोम्बोक्सिन A2 एंड विच अट्रैक्ट्स मोर प्लेटलेट्स, दैट प्लेटलेट गेट एक्टिवेटेड व्हेन एंड देन द डिफरेंट प्लेटलेट्स दे एक्चुअली अडहेयर वन आफ्टर अनदर एंड दिस इज हाउ दे फॉर्म अ प्लेटलेट क्लब. सो how the platelet plug is formed, you can see here, whenever there is a damage to the vessel wall, collagen is exposed and the platelets, they come and bind directly with the collagen or through the von Willebrand factor. Okay, then as soon as they adhere, they get activated, and once they get activated, they have projections on its surface, and then these projections, what happens that these projections, they show the activeness. Actually the now the platelet has become active and it releases different substances from its granules, and the most important of these are the thrombopsin A2. This 5-HT is what? Serotonin, ADP, thromboxane, A2. So this actually thromboxane A2 and ATP, they are actually powerful platelet aggregator. What they will do, they will call other platelets, and more platelets will come here, and they all will aggregate over here, and they will form a platelet plug which will stop bleeding. Okay? But this is a temporary plug, and it will naturally be replaced by the blood clot. Now, importance of platelet plug is very important for closing the vascular ports. As I told you that there are minute ruptures whenever our blood is flowing with a high velocity, the vessel actually, there are minute ruptures in the vessel wall, and it occurs thousands of times daily. So if, and those holes, they are sealed by the platelets, and if less platelets in a person, okay, so what will happen, he will develop 1000 hemorrhages, like this small dotted hemorrhages, which are known as petechia or purpura. Okay, and these are showing, this is just because that platelets, they are insufficient to close those minute holes which are occurring daily thousands of times. So this shows the importance of platelets in closing those small holes in the blood vessels. So deficiency of platelets may lead to petechia or hemorrhages under the skin. So this finishes your class of this primary hemostasis. I just summarized in 2 minutes that primary hemostasis is actually involve two main processes, vascular spasm, and second is the platelet plug formation. We did the vascular spasm, that if vascular spasm is achieved by mainly nervous reflex, myogenic reflex, and certain hormonal reflex, that is by the certain hormones. And the primary hemostasis, second step is the platelet plug formation. The platelet plug formation is actually achieved by 3 A's. You have to remember that the platelets, they first of all get adhered, then they get activated and they release their content, then the platelets actually aggregate. So this platelet aggregation finally leads to the formation of platelet plug, which temporarily seals the hole that occurs in the blood vessel. Now let's discuss some of the questions. Question number 1. Which of the following promotes platelet plug formation? The options are endothelin, nitric oxide, prostacyclin, and thromboxane A2. Yes, what would be the answer? platelet plug formation, platelet aggregation is the function of thromboxane A2. You remember, must remember that this prostacyclin, this has got opposite action of the thromboxane A2. Thromboxane A2 is powerful vasoconstrictor and platelet aggregator, and prostacyclin, it inhibits platelet aggregation and it is it prevents platelet aggregation and it causes vasodilation. Nitric oxide is also producing vasodilation, and endothelin, we discussed that it has a role in the vascular spasm. The second question is, which of the following factors released from the platelets promote vasospasm? Now, if you remember the first step of hemostasis, that is vasospasm, there are certain factors which are released from the platelets and which help in vasospasm. What is that substance? Is it bradykinin, nitric oxide, prostacyclin or serotonin? So what is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is serotonin, which is released from the dense granules. Remember, dense granules se release hota hai na? Sac release hota tha. Sac, S is serotonin, A is ADP and C is calcium ions. Now question number 3, which of the following substance acts as a glue to cause adhesion of first layer of platelets with subendothelial collagen? Glue ke taur pe kaam karta hai. Kaun sa hai? This is prostacyclin. PGI2 ka other naam is prostacyclin. Jo aapne pehle padha tha. Theek hai, wo platelet aggregation ko inhibit karta hai. Second is fibrinogen. It's a clotting factor 1. Thromboxane A2, it helps in the platelet aggregation, but it does not act as a glue. The glue is actually the von Willebrand factor. Okay, G. Thank you, student. Thank you for listening. If you find any difficulty, you can contact me on my email. Stay blessed.